Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to Teacup Tarot. In today's video, we are going to be taking a look at what your Akashic records have to say about you. Now, this has been a video that has been very highly requested, and I just decided before the end of the year was the right time to just film this. Now, having said that, you have three piles in front of you. Please make sure to pick a pile that really speaks to you. And then we shall start with pile one. Hello, and if you've selected pile one, this is what your Akashic records have to say about you. Now, first of all, pile one, in this lifetime, you are meant to be somebody who's infinitely kind, who's infinitely generous, who's infinitely compassionate, somebody who wears their heart on their sleeve, and somebody who cares not only for people that they're born with, not only their friends, their family, but also sometimes even unexpected strangers. You are likely to be people who are very compassionate towards humanity at large and just want everybody to have a good life. You just are meant to be somebody who just has excellent intentions for just about everybody. Now, also, your relationships are at the forefront in your life. It's almost like you live for your friends, you live for your family, you live for the people you care about, okay? Especially your intimate relationship in the nature of marriage are always going to be very important for you, yeah? You're born to be a wife, you're born to be a husband, you're born to be a father, mother, a grandparent. That is the impression that I'm getting here. But sometimes what may happen is, it is your relationship that tests you to the deepest level. But knowing you and the resilient person that you are, every test that you come across, you will pass it with flying colors, because your commitment towards your relationship is definitely not questionable. Now, you know, like I mentioned, you have a healing heart, you know. People in your presence feel better. People in your presence and with your guidance feel like they can do just about anything in their lifetime, yeah? Also, in your lifetime, I feel like, you know, you're meant to be a healer in some capacity. Personally, I get this as, you know, like a profession of healing, like doctors, psychologists, nurses, allied professions. That is the impression that I'm really getting here. If you are one of these professions that you're doing just right, even otherwise, in some capacity, you will act as a healer for a lot of people in your life. One thing that may be slightly problematic to you is, you know, you may have the best of intentions, you may have brilliant plans for your life, but the execution part is slightly, you know, on shaky grounds. Like, you may have so much on your mind, but when it comes to doing things, you are a little on the back foot. So that is something you have to pay careful attention to. So when you start a project, you have to start it with the intention of completing it and following it through. Remember this, okay? Whatever you start, complete it. That is the message coming through for you. Now, you're also likely to be born people who are supremely intelligent, who know how to use their mind in just the best way possible. And you are also likely to be people who are a little slow, is what I'm getting here, you know. You're very intentional, you're very deliberate. And if something doesn't speak to you, you're not going to do it. If you love something, you'll just pour your heart and soul into it. But if not, you're like, no. That's not for me. But incredibly wise, incredibly strong in mind is what I'm getting here. Also for you, pile one, you know, one of the major things for you in this lifetime is a relationship with the spirit. Without a connection with spirituality, without a connection with God, without a connection with your creator, you'll almost be like a ship without, you know, just having an anchor. You'll just float from here to there. It is only when you find a deep root in spirituality will your life truly, truly progress and head in a direction that it is meant to in this lifetime. Also, pile one, you're born with a lot of gift, okay? But I also see a frequent shift in your career for you. So one time you may decide you want to do it. Second time you're like, oh, you know, maybe this calls to you and you want to get in that direction. Because like I said, you know, follow through may be a little bit of a problem for you. So sticking to one thing may not come easily. But this is just something that you are. But I believe if you are able to intentionally steer, you know, your ship in a particular direction, you will be able to do that. But you're born with incredible gifts, incredible talents, so use it to the best of your ability is also something that is being told to you. Now, one thing that is supremely important to you in this lifetime is your connection with the natural world, is your connection with the world of elementals. Yeah, you get your power from earth, Mother Earth. Everything that Mother Earth personifies, yeah, this can be trees, this can be forests, this could be rivers, ponds. You are a nature's child. And it is like, you know, like our cell phones, we need like a charger to recharge it. For you, nature is your recharge. So spend as much time as you can outdoors, because out there is where you feel most at home. In this lifetime is what is coming forth. In fact, the impression that I'm getting here is, in a previous lifetime, you belong to a nomadic tribe who lived in the outdoors, okay? Which is why your soul sort of has that yearning, and that will continue in this lifetime as well. And in fact, that yearning is always going to continue for you is what is coming forth. In fact, in the future, I'll not be surprised if you have like your own farm, or you grow your own vegetables, or live in a place which is filled with nature, surrounded by nature. That is what is coming forth. Now, in this lifetime, you're meant to be financially very, very successful, okay? The goddess of fortune, the goddess of abundance is always going to be very, very benevolent towards you. But one thing that is going to be very notable about you is, the more you give, the more you get. So, you know, whenever you get money, even if this is $10, make sure you share a little bit of that with somebody, because in sharing, you attract more to yourself in this lifetime. Is what is coming forth. Yeah, makes sense. You know, like I told you, following through with things may be a little bit problematic for you. So discipline, boundaries, having a plan and having a structure for your life is infinitely, you know, important for you, because without a firm structure to your life, without boundaries, you know, things may not work out. So boundaries, structures is your thing is what is coming forth. Now, in your life, you're meant to create something that is little short for masterpieces, what is coming forth, yeah? This is creation from your heart. Remember, this is not something that you've inspired from others. This is an original piece of work that will come through you, okay? For some, this can be a piece of work. For some, this could be a scholaristic piece of writing or writing for a journal. That is what is coming forth. But this is in the form of writing is what is coming forth. So, you know, please make sure you're channeling your energies accordingly. Now, one thing that is notable about you in this lifetime is you like to hold on to things, you know. You're like, I want to hold on to my family. I want to hold on to, you know, my home. I just want to hold everything close. In a way, the sense I get is getting out of comfort zones may not be very easy to you, but by trying really hard, will you succeed at it? That's what's coming forth, yeah. But of course, once again, materially, you guys are going to be succeeding a lot is what is coming forth. Once again, you're born very strong in your mind, okay? You're very curious. You want to learn about everything. You want to learn this. You want to learn that. And that is the kind of person you are. You're meant to be very, very wise. But it's almost going to be, you're going to be a jack of all trades, yeah? But remember to master something. You're meant to master something in this lifetime and become a scholar at it is what is coming through, yeah? Learning is good in all directions, learning is good. But remember to pick one thing and stick to it, because that's going to be important in this lifetime. Now, one thing that I see for you especially is property. I see land for you, I see vehicle for you, I see a home for you. And all of this in this lifetime, you will be creating with your own sheer hard work. You may not so much get the help of somebody in your life. Like, even if you have that help, you know, honestly, I don't see you guys taking it, because you're very independent, you're very strong. So everything that you create for yourself, your land, your property, your home, your vehicle, you will buy it with your own hard work, because that is the way it is meant to in this lifetime. And also, you are going to have a beautiful sense of humor, okay? This is almost like, no matter what happens in your life, You have this intrinsic ability to smile through everything, to smile through your good times, your bad times. Like you could be having a really horrible day and the person sitting next to you will be like, oh, I never really knew this about that person. Yeah, but that is what makes you shine so bright. You know, it's almost like your connection with your inner child is strong at all point of time, and that is what makes you special. Your sense of humor, your laughter, the joy, the positivity with which you're brimming all the time is the essence of who you truly are. And that is the person that the people will remember in this lifetime. Somebody who brought happiness in their life, somebody who brought fulfillment in their life, and somebody who brought love in their life is what you will be remembered as. Now, this is exactly what is written in your Akashic records. Now, I have given a couple of advice. Please, guys, as much as you can, remember it and work towards it. Because my intention for you always is that you make your life into a beautiful piece of work and that you live the best life ever. And I really, really sincerely hope that you are going to be able to do this in this lifetime. Remember, you're incredibly powerful, you're incredibly brave, strong, and beautiful. And I completely, completely, 100% believe in you. Never doubt that for a second. I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, and if you've selected pile 2, this is what is written in your Akashic records, and let us take a look at it. Now, first of all, for you, pile 1, in this lifetime, you're meant to be blessed. In this lifetime, you're meant to be abundant. You are somebody who's meant to have their wishes fulfilled. Yeah? And almost, the sense I get it is, this is going to happen almost by magic. You're just being you. You're doing that feels natural to you. And in doing that, you'll get the success that you desire. Materially, I see you guys living a really, really good life in this lifetime. Yeah? One more thing that I see for you is, you know, you are meant to be an artist of sort, okay? Now, by artist, it can of course be like a proper artist, but whatever life you live, you're meant to become almost like, you know, the sculptor of your life is what I'm getting here, yeah? You'll build your life in a way as if you are like a co-creator with spirit. So when it comes to making every choice, make it very intentionally, make it very consciously, because it is in a way your thinking that dictates your mind. You will be able to become the master of your destiny should you take your role very, very seriously. So please ensure whatever you're doing, you're thinking things through very, very properly. Yeah. Another thing that is coming through for you is in this lifetime, you're meant to guide a lot of people. You're meant to help a lot of people. You are meant to give a lot. So service actually may be a path for you. Okay. And this is unconditional service without getting, you know, anything in return or without having the desire to get anything in return. Remember this pile too. The best giving is when you give it without intention of receiving, and that is exactly who you're meant to in this lifetime. Remember, you're being promised rewards right in the beginning. So when you give with a generous heart, you are going to be blessed by a divine power with whatever it is that you so desire is what is coming through. Now, also in this lifetime, you're likely to be people who are very ambitious, people who are likely to take bold steps and likely to burn the midnight lamp when it comes to wanting whatever it is that you're wanting. Yeah, it is important for you to channel your ambition in the right manner, channel your heart's desire in the right manner, because that is very important for you. Okay, channeling your desires, remember that always. Now, it is also important for you to understand that just having an intention is not enough. Like, you could have the best of intention, but if you do not act on it, if you do not believe it to be possible for you, it won't happen for you. For you, just intention is not enough. Intention is the key for everything, but your belief is actually the lock for the key. So never doubt yourself, never doubt your ability, and never doubt what your future is capable for you to unlock. Yeah. Also, I feel like in this lifetime, you're meant to have friends and family who are very supportive of you, who care about you a great deal, and who'll stand with you when you need them. Sometimes these people may come in a little late in life, Or, you know, there may be times where you feel like I'm very isolated, but when you need help, help is going to be available for you. And in a way, the way I see it is, you know, this can come in the form of a stranger in some cases. You know, you don't even know this person, but this person shapes your life in a beautiful way possible. So that is the kind of friendship that you are going to be enjoying in this lifetime. Now, one thing that you have to develop in this lifetime is your confidence. You know, if you are confident about your own ability, if you're confident that you will be able to succeed in this lifetime, there is nothing that you cannot do, because you're born with infinite capacities to have whatever it is that you want. Believe in your own self, believe in your own strength, believe in your own wisdom is what is coming through for you. And also, I feel like in this lifetime, you may have to be very careful about the way you dress, the way you appear to the world, yeah, because your appearance to the world holds the key to your success is also something that is coming forth for you. Now, one thing that is going to be important for you is you need to be able to protect yourself. Now, if you have any plans in your lifetime, do not reveal it to just about anybody. You know, don't go and tell the world that, okay, this is what I want to do, this is what I want to do. Because in telling the world your story right before things are meant to happen, you may see that they fail in some way, yeah? So it is important for you to protect your energies, protect your dreams is also what is coming through for you. Now, one of the challenges in your lifetime is to surrender unhealthy relationship patterns. Sometimes, pile to you have, you know, a tendency to stick to people even though they do not need you, or hold on to relationships when you should be leaving them, you know, free is what I'm getting here, yeah? The more you go on and hold on to people, the more they will want not to associate with you. Now, this is a karma that you're carrying from a previous lifetime. So in this lifetime, please make sure to work it out. Remember, if you truly, truly love somebody, just let them go. Let them live the best way possible. Let them live in a way that speaks to them in the best way possible, yeah? Because in giving them that freedom, you will get the respect that you so desire from them is what is coming through for you. Now, one thing that you have to learn to cultivate in this lifetime is stillness of mind. You need to make meditation a priority in your life. There is no way around it. Without meditation, you'll almost feel like, you know, you're very ungrounded, or you're going in one direction in one time, second direction in second time, and not really, you know, going in any particular direction, yeah? So ground your energies and truly ask yourself, what do I want? What do I want? And then head in that direction. Don't go, you know, traveling in too many directions or do too many things at the same time, because you'll not succeed in them. Stick to one thing, do it well, and then move on to other. That is the way you have to move forward with things, yeah? Stillness of mind, grounding your energies is absolutely needed for you in this lifetime. Now, one thing that you're meant to do in this lifetime is also to be fair. Remember, never, ever, ever be unfair to somebody. Never be unkind to somebody. Do not treat people with disrespect, because every action that you do is going to be judged, and it will come back to you sometime in this lifetime. Yeah, keep that in mind very, very carefully, because like I told you, you're the creator of your life. So when a person is a creator, everything that they create creates a karma. So create your karmas very, very consciously, and you know, just make sure you're doing good in this world. Make sure you're doing good, and treating people fairly is going to be important for you. One thing that is important is your ability to trust in life. Without a trust in life, without a trust in future and a higher power, things are not going to work out, yeah? Have faith, and with your faith, ways will be shown to you. Even if there is no way, a way will be made for you is what is coming forth for you. Remember, your faith is what is going to really move mountains for you. So please be people of faith is what is coming through for you. And also, I feel like you're going to be somebody who's going to give with an open heart. Your relationships are going to be important to you. Your friendships are going to be important to you. In fact, your family is the most important thing in this lifetime, period. In fact, I will not be surprised if a couple of you just end up choosing your families and just having a career around it is what is coming forth, yeah? But caring for people, caring for family, caring for people who are sometimes not even related to you is also a part of your karma, yeah? Remember that always. Now, one thing that is going to be important in your life is slow and deliberate moment. Sometimes you may feel like, the success that I so wish in this lifetime is not coming to me as easily as it comes to my friends. The reason for that is you're meant to be somebody who's going to succeed largely in life. So do not worry about when that success is coming. Do the hard work, because it's almost going to be like, your destiny or the fate for you changes in one moment. Like you did not even realize that success was around the corner and it comes to you. So make sure you're working in a methodical manner. Make sure you're working in a way that really works for you and just do a job well. Yeah, deliberately, intentionally, and with a belief in your own abilities is what is coming true for you. Now, one thing that you really have to stay away from is indecisiveness, heading in too many directions at the same time. Being stuck with too many things in your head, okay? Like I told you, if you want to succeed in this lifetime, you have to pick one thing, do it really well, become known for it, and then move in a different direction. Yeah, don't sort of go in circles is what I'm getting here. Stick to one thing, head in that direction, and you will be beautifully done. Yeah, remember, success is assured for you. Monetary success is assured for you. Wealth is assured for you. And you have everything that it takes to succeed. Just create your life in a way that speaks to you the most. Do not sort of listen to anybody or do not follow anybody's advice, especially people you do not trust. Because, like I told you, if you reveal plans to people and then they give you a different direction and you'll be like, oh, I wish I never told them something in the first place. Yeah. Remember, I really, really want you guys to succeed in life. So some things that I'm telling here, please, 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 please take a note of it, because these things are important, guys. If you just keep a note of little things here and there, your success is going to be large is what is coming through. And it's going to be a success that nobody can take away from you. And that is true success in itself. Remember that always. A lifelong success, a success with strong foundations. Because that is the kind of success that you're meant to have in this lifetime. Yeah, overall, that is what I have for you when it comes to your Akashic records. As always, all my prayers are with you. All my good wishes are with you. I believe in you guys, pile two, and I know you'll succeed. You're meant to. Yeah, have faith in God. God is the supreme power for you. Your faith in Him can change things. Always have faith. Yeah, I'll see you in my next one. Bye. Hello, and if you've selected pile 3, this is what is written in your Akashic records. Now, first of all, for you pile 3, your ancestors or something to do with your ancestors is always going to be a huge part of your life, okay? I especially see this in the form of one ancestor who you're very, very closely connected with. And in a way, it is his work that you're carrying forward in this lifetime. Remember that you're born with a specific purpose that an ancestor carried on before you. So I will not be surprised if you belong to shamanic families or you belong to a family where one particular person had a almost spiritual ability, had a divine ability, and that is sort of passed on through your lineage. It has missed certain members of your family, but it has come to you. Yeah. So in your lifetime, you're meant to be somebody who has the ability to help people in a spiritual manner, who has the ability to almost become a seer, a visionary in this lifetime. Yeah. Also, you're likely to be a person who holds a lot of answers to the problems of your family in this lifetime is also coming forth. But, the knowledge that you have, the wisdom that you have, it is born with you. Okay, it's not something you're going to inculcate in this lifetime. Of course, you're going to be keeping on learning more. But whatever you are meant to do in this lifetime, you are trained for it in your previous lifetime as well. And you're born with a specific purpose that an ancestor set forth in his lifetime. Yeah. Now, also, you know, in your life, you're going to have situations where things are less than perfect, where you don't have much, you don't have much support. You feel like, what am I even doing in this world? Why are things so tough? And then there'll be times where everything is beautiful, everything is happy, everything is successful. You have positivity in your life, okay? Remember, everything negative that happens in your life is meant for you in this lifetime to experience, because it is the karma that you're carrying from a previous lifetime. And in a way, you're here to work out a lot of your karma, because, you know, in working out that karma, I believe you are in almost like the final stages of, you know, that final release, that moksha is what is coming through for you. So please be very careful about not picking up new karmas on your way forward, because, you know, just work things out is what I'm really getting here. Now, one thing that is going to be infinitely important for you in this lifetime is your ability to care for children. Yeah, children are almost a central part of your life purpose. So this could involve having your own children, caring for children who are sometimes not your own, like family's kids or your sister's kids, your brother's kids, those kind of things. But of course, this could even be kids that are like orphans, kids who do not have anybody in the world, and you will be people who care for them. Yeah, but kids are a huge part of your life purpose is what is coming through from your Akashic records. Now, one thing you have to be very careful of is your ability to doubt yourself. Yeah, remember, you're born with infinite capacities. You've been training for this for a lifetime. I honestly do not understand why you even doubt yourself for a second. So whatever doubt you have, invite Archangel Michael to cut those cords of doubt and set you free. Again, the doubts can also be like a karma, you know, that you're carrying from a past life. So, you know, just make sure you're working on that, because that working that out is very important for you. Yeah. Yes, absolutely. You know, right at the beginning, you know, when I started this video, I was getting an impression of ancestral blessings in your life. And you have the white raven spirit, which in itself signifies a very, very powerful presence of an ancestor in your life. An ancestor with magical abilities who has passed on the gift to you is what is coming forth. Remember, and your job is to build on that gift. The gift will become only stronger with you, and you in turn will pass it on to your children. This is a lineage full of gifts. Yeah, that is what is coming forth. You're meant to help a lot of people with your wisdom, with your abilities is also something that is coming forth as well. Now, you know, it's almost beautiful. You know, nothing in your lifetime is set in stone. You know, you are almost given like a blueprint, and God, your creator, has told you, make the most of it. I give you free will. Make the use of your free will. So of course, you know, we all are bound by destiny. We all are bound by a particular plan, like a fate. But for you, you have a way out of making a life for yourself is what is coming forth, okay? So please make sure to create a beautiful life for yourself, to use your gift in a beautiful manner, to create a life that just speaks right for you is what is coming forth. You are meant to be a force of good in the world, okay? See, even if your gifts are not used on a global platform, even if your gifts are not used on a public platform, you are meant to do good in this world. Especially through your work is what I'm getting here, you know. Now, maybe your career will be in fields that, you know, bring you in contact with people who need you at that particular time. Remember, you don't have to go to anybody in this lifetime. People who need you will come to you and get your assistance. Yeah, you just hold on to your own power. You just hold on to that bright light that you have, and make sure you have a connection with God, the spirit, very, very strong. Because all the energy that you get it directly from God. That is what is coming forth. Yeah. And you're very, very wise. You know, you're born wise. Now, one thing that you have to be very careful of is your belief in scarcity. You know what I feel like, pile three, in a previous lifetime, you had a vow of, you know, not accepting too much money in your life. There is a very, very strong possibility that in your previous lifetime, you may actually have given up the material world for a life of, you know, somebody who's left their family, like a monk is what I'm getting here. So because of that, you know, being a monk, I feel like, you know, that belief in scarcity is strong in you. Like, you know, they have a vow of not accepting too much money. And I feel like you're carrying that in this lifetime as well. So cut cords with that. And which is why you already have a strong presence of Archangel Michael, yeah? Now, like I told you, you know, in this lifetime, you are meant to work out a lot of karmas. And once you work out that karma, you're free. You're free. That is what I'm getting here. I'm telling you, this is your last lifetime. Because you're passing on the gift to your children and you're free. You will have done the job that you're born to do in this lifetime. And that is exactly what is written in the Akashic realm for you. And also be careful about your karmas. Make sure you're intentionally doing good for the world, because in doing good selflessly, you will get what you seek. Yes, you know, okay, now this makes things really clear. You know, remember I told you that, you know, you've been training for this in since a past lifetime, and of course you've been training for this in this lifetime as well, you know, because, you know, like I told you, the scarcity and the monk once again. So you left the world for the good of the world, you know, left the world as in the material world for the good of the world. And monks are meant for prayers. Monks bless people. The presence of monks heal people. And that is what you did in your last life. Yeah. But for some reason, you created karmas. You accumulated some karmas. And those are the karmas that you're meant to release in this lifetime. Yeah. And you will be doing that very, very effectively, is what I really see here for you. Now, interestingly, what I also find for you is that you may have a certain kind of resistance when it comes to doing certain things, okay? See, what may happen is sometimes you do good to people and you feel like, oh, I'm not really getting anything in return. Like, I'm being kind to somebody, I'm being really good to people, and yet people are unkind to me. They treat me unfairly. So that is the kind of belief that you're going to be having within you. But that is exactly what you need to work out, yeah? See, your job is of a higher level. People may treat you in a particular manner, but you have to stick to your karma of doing well. That is where your test lies, and that is what your Akashic records are here to tell you. You have to do good, and remember, every good thing that you get from your life, in your life, is from God. Don't really look at people. See, people are just souls who are like you. In fact, people are sometimes soul of a lesser level from you, who vibrate as a lesser level from you. So don't really expect them to match your capacity. Just look to God, and that is where you'll get all your answers. Because, you know, you already know the way forward. You were already a monk in a previous lifetime. Your connection with God is meant to be very, very strong in this lifetime as well. Now, one thing that is going to be very important for you is that, you know, you will walk away from things that are familiar. So, you know, especially when it comes to success, especially when it comes to, you know, everything good in your life, it'll come to you away from home, you know, away from people who are born with, especially your own family. Yeah, that's what's coming through. So I will not be surprised that, you know, you move away from your family, or you're naturally taken away from them, is what I'm getting here. Sometimes you may live in a different city from them. Sometimes you may just live, you know, in an entirely different country altogether, because in a way, this is what you're meant for in this lifetime. Away from your family so that you can sort of let go of that connection with people and do good for the world. Yeah, that's what's coming through for you. Your job is not just for your family or your friends. It is for the world. You belong to the world. Remember, selfless service, that is what you're meant to in this lifetime. Now, it is important for you to have great amount of clarity towards what you want to do in this lifetime. Yeah, remember, what profession you choose, remember to choose professions that involve giving in some kind. Now, you could be, you know, like, you could be doctors, you could be healers, you could be teachers, you could be, you know, people who belong to the service industry. Now, service industries are numerous. In fact, service industries can also make you money, you know, like the hotel industry, travel industry. But giving service to people is your job in this lifetime. Yeah, because in coming in contact with people is when you're going to be doing your job. So that really makes sense, doesn't it? So you need to have clarity around that. Yeah. Now, one thing that is going to be very, very, very important to you in this lifetime is to make conscious choices. You know, sometimes we are like, you know, I'll just go with the flow. I'll see where life takes me. That also works to a beautiful level. But for you, because you are meant to live a very, very heart-centered life, a very intentional life, it is important for you to be very, very careful about what choices you're making. Because remember, it is your last lifetime. You're meant to work out those karmas. So everything that you do, be very conscious of what you're doing is also coming through. Now, one thing that you have to let go of in this lifetime is your past. Okay, don't hold on to your past, because your Akashic records tell you that you may have suffered in some form or the other in your past, but it's important for you to understand that those were your karmas. It was meant to happen for you. If it hadn't happened in a way that it did in your past, it would have happened in another fashion. But it was meant to happen because it is your own doing. Yeah, remember, whatever happened, let it go. Focus on your future, focus on the present, focus on doing good, and focus on being the catalyst of change in the lifetime of other people. Remember, selfless service, even in this lifetime, is the way forward for you. Money is not going to be a problem. Just if you want it, remember to, you know, sever the ties of that, you know, monk-like nature that you have in you. You know, monks are not allowed to have money. Monks live very simply, and maybe why this is why you had that vow of not having much. So cut that cords of that, you know, scarcity kind of mindset. Invite Archangel Michael to cut that cords for you. So moving forward, you'll be able to enjoy a life of luxury, enjoy a life where money is there, prosperity is there, and everything that you want is there, is what is coming through for you. Overall, that is what is written in your Akashic records. You guys are advanced souls to a T, and you know, if this is your last lifetime, what else remains to be said? Like, people usually have lifetimes to still work out. You don't. That sets you apart. Yeah? So concentrate on your karmas, do good, and treat people with kindness. Because that's the essence of who you are and who you are meant to be in this lifetime. I wish you the very, very best, and my sincere, sincere prayers are always with you, Bhal 3. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.